If there's one thing I love in game, that's to support my team through thick and thin in whatever hardcore content I am in. It could be in Master Vogue, Master Nightfall, Master Empire Hunt, Scrum Masters, and even Trials, and no matter what I'm up against, I'll always be there to help. But for me to do my job, I will need an effective build that brings out the inner supportive role for me and my team to start. And for this, I have an absolutely bonkers of a build that will cover all main aspects of difficulty you'll participate in. But most importantly, you're going to be getting your super and abilities back within seconds. This Well of Radiance build is the new top dog for all endgame content as it vastly improves on the old methods we used, but also brings in some new flesh to the build. If you've never believed in God, well, this build will show you the light of the Almighty, and if that doesn't work for you, I suggest you go play the Bee Gees Stayin' Alive song. That also works as well. Before we head in, if you enjoyed the video, then I really appreciate a like and a sub as it goes a long way for me. From the side class, we will be using, of course, the Attunement of Grace, as this is considered one of the best support-based subclass that offers the most to everyone in any scenario. Although Titans with Banner Shield are more flexible in how much areas they cover and how they can produce more orbs of light like a Seahorse and Heat, Attunement of Grace is more simple and straight to the point, to which little to no communication is required at times for activating your super and making others aware. When you use a subclass, you can pretty much set yourself up for a supportive role as every perk within the tree are designed for supporting in mind. Benevolent Dawn will grant you ability energy when you empower or heal others within your rift, while Guardian Flames will empower you and your team upon melee hits. Even Divine Protection, which provides overshield to your allies via your charged grenades, can come in clutch for the most harrowing encounters you are in. All of these will play a pivotal role in the build, not just one. However, to support our abilities as best we can, Elemental World mods will play a strong part in how the build functions and how often you can rely on your abilities the most. For example, Elemental Ordnance, Armaments, and Bountiful Well will allow me to create wells via solo weapons and grenades, but also allow me to produce two wells for each activation mod. Considering how often you're going to be using the two hand in hand, I'll be producing four wells in one go, with two wells being enough to grant me half to a full ability energy return. So while you're empowering others, you'll also be producing enough wealth to keep your team's abilities afloat. If this does not pique your interest, and I mean really not pique your interest, then you've definitely gone mad as this can become super effective when your team are relying on a strat which heavily requires ability usage. Now, within the subclass and wells being used, you're going to need something to pair it up with, and ideally it's going to need to be solo in the process. We have a vast selection of items you can pick for this, so there isn't a must-have setup, but there is a guaranteed setup that will offer you the most. I take my primary, which is the Chroma Rush with Feeding Frenzy and Wellspring. The point of this weapon is to help further support abilities when we need a small bump here and there, but also to counter any combatants that are too much to handle there with our bow. A 60 in the magazine with Feeding Frenzy at the helm makes it one of the best ARs to bring with you into endgame because of how fast and rewarding a weapon can be. You can move through minor to major combatants back to back without the need of empowering buffs, and while you're at it, you'll be producing small but noticeable amount of ability energy as you go. On top of this, you'll need an anti-barrier weapon depending on the encounter you face, and this is going to be a great pairing because of its fast RPM and how you can prime a target with your bow and then finish with your AR easily. It will obliterate shields, and the majority of combatants you face will become a breeze once you go through them. For secondary, I'm using the Tiku's Divination Exotic Bow, and ideally this will allow us to produce wells actively with the Elemental Armaments mod attached, while also covering my overload options as they will become a menace in high-end content. A great bow that's capable of taking out a large group of combatants in 1-2 shots once primed, and can chain this fiery explosion to clear out areas quickly and effectively without needing to get in close to do so. With the bow and the grenades, both having specific mods to allow me to produce wells at the same time, I can constantly produce enough wells or orbs of power to keep my team moving and actively alive. Remember, the wells will benefit us the most as we can empower and provide overshields to our team as many times as we like, as long as we have our rifts available, and when we collect wells as necessary. To help with the collection part, I have attached the Seeking Wells mod that will actively come towards me and my team once within its vicinity, and as long as we go near them, then they will follow us wherever we go. For our heavy, I've chosen to use Reed's Regret with Vorpal and Quickdraw, and this will be used for taking out the heavy hitters we will be facing. Great DPS, as Vorpal will be providing that extra damaging power to take out champions to bosses within a few hits, and as I have Parkour Deconstruction applied, it means all damage from all areas will be increased drastically. Think about all that empowering buffs we have going on, and then apply that onto a boss, or even a champion. it'll take a good chunk of health out of them before they're even able to fight back, which is exactly what we need. Now within the stats, all of our abilities will be covered by the plethora of energy coming our way via the elemental mods and using Benevolent Dawn to its fullest, so nothing needs to be maxed out fully. However, if we want to keep the abilities going, I would say go all in within your recovery stat so you can activate BD more often, which will feed back into everything else and get your super up within a few seconds or less. For this, aim for 80 as it will give the most beneficial amount you should aim for, but also will leave you enough space to slot in mods if need be. 9 times out of 10, you won't need to add any more mods for this area as it can be easily built up via armor stats alone. And from here, we then go for discipline since we'll be using that a lot throughout as well. 50 to 60 is reasonable enough for passive energy as with elemental ordnance, bountiful well, absolution, innovation, and the subclass tree perks in action. These should all be enough for you to fully get your abilities back up the moment you use them. If you like, you can also add in the grenade kickstart mod for even more grenade energy return, but only if you plan to not use an anti-champion mod for your gauntlets. And now for the most important part of the build, your intellect, which I have mine at 50. But wait, there's a good reason for that. With the exotic Phoenix Protocol, once I use my super and get kills within it, I can get super energy back for doing so, which within the design of the build, means I can easily gain back 50 to even 100% of my super back within the duration I have. But for us to get this level first, we need to build up super, and for this I have Hands On and Ashes to Assets, both being tied into two abilities I plan to fully use non-stop, and both having perks within the subclass tree that they can benefit from. With the amount of energy I will be building up for this, we can blow through energy regen for this area and have it up in second if we play our cards right. Leftover wise, we have the Elemental Armored mod, which will allow our solar weapons to produce wells, which will play a big role in how often we use our abilities. We then have the Font of Might for that extra damage boost when we pick up elemental wells, which will greatly help us within the higher tier content and tougher combatants we face. We then have Seeking Wells, which will allow our wells to track me and my team once we are nearby them. And then lastly, we have the Particle Deconstruction mod for that major debuff on combatants via fusions to linear fusions being used. Now as we have covered every bit of the build that you need to familiarize yourself with, here's what the build looks like once we compiled it into one. For head, we have Resilience, Hands On, Ashes to Assets and Bountiful World mod. Arm, we have Overload Bow, Unstoppable Fusion Rifle and Elemental Ordnance mod. Chest, we have Resilience, Concussive Dampener, Sniper Damage Resistance and Elemental Armors mod. Leg, we have Maya Discipline, Absolution, Innovation and Fondant Bite mod. Bond, we have Minor Resilience, Parkour Deconstruction and Seek and Wells mod. Being a support based role in most RPG games tends to rely on the user providing constant buffs and debuffs all around them rather than fight back with weapons at times, but I think this time around we have achieved a pretty good setup that covers all these aspects in one and not leave the user out in the wind. The general idea of the build is to provide as much buffs as we can to our team so they can keep fighting while also garnering super energy and empowerment through simple means such as collecting wells, or throwing out grenades, or simply placing a rift down, etc. And also putting the hurt down onto those who decide to challenge us. Our subclass alongside Phoenix Protocol will allow us to net more super energy after using our super the first time round, and then if done correctly we can chain it within a short time frame of their selves. With the damage bonuses we get and mods such as Phantom Might being available, we can one-shot the majority of combatants easily via our weapons and then heavily use our grenades and abilities to spawn multiple amounts of wells and orbs of power as we go along, to the point that our team can then use their super if they wish, and we can follow through again as we will have enough to use ours again after our first super is down. In simple terms and layman terms, we will rotate supers so that we will always have super available no matter the situation. As you can see, the build is pretty streamlined in terms of how it does this, as everything is so linked together that no matter how hard the situation is, you'll still have room to make up whatever area you felt in. And on top of that, as a support slash attacker build, you can customize mods and weapons to your choosing and still gain the same effects as what's being shown now. For example, you can swap out your exotic for Arbalest if you want to bypass shields easily and debuff at the same time, or you can swap into 1000 Voices if you want to destroy bosses in an instance. Mods now, you can add in the Time Dilation mod to increase the duration that most of your mods offer, or you can swap in the Frontal Wisdom mod for even faster super regeneration on a passive scale. If you want to see how well it works, it acts very similar to how my Ursa build worked, as both can adapt to different scenarios without needing to change so much of their identity. You can still be a tank against all those you face and still be able to hit hard as long as you play your cards right and still gain all these benefits at the same time. For an endgame build, the setup is as simple as it needs to be, but the results provided will give you the best experience you'll need to survive the deepest and dankest of tough contents you face. This is a build fit for kings and queens, as everything you touch will detonate, and everything that dies by you will grant you energy and super for doing so. With Witch Queen just around the corner, now's the perfect time to dust off your Phoenix and prep for a new adventure to come. We may get some new mods at the same time, but elemental worlds at the moment are pretty strong, and with this build here, I think we just made them even more stronger. So if you enjoyed the video, then please leave a like and sub, and also follow me on Twitter to keep up to date with Destiny content if you did that type of stuff, link is down below. But once again, thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you all in the next one.